We just came back from the crash site. There was a group of 25 of us. We're expert monitors with the OSCE, and we were greeted not in the most hospitable way, I should say. And also, there was a lot of chaos there. What we observed were already bodies starting to partially decompose in the hot sun. We saw a lot of debris. The debris doesn't look like it's been manipulated in any way, but there's lots of it. The crash area is very, very big, but we were only given a very small area to actually monitor. And we were greeted almost with hostility. So it wasn't a visit that was done under the best conditions, and we hope to continue again tomorrow.
Who are you actually dealing with now? I mean, is there an individual of any credibility who you're dealing with?
Well, before we left Kiev, there were high-level talks, the tripartite group. You probably
heard. I mean on the ground, right where you are, Michael, where you are, on the ground at the crime scene.
We asked for the commander, the leader. No one showed up. There was one gentleman there in a uniform, heavily armed and apparently somewhat intoxicated, who wasn't very hospitable or helpful at all. In fact, at the end, he kind of rushed all of us away, including the journalists. So there has to be order reestablished very, very quickly. Those bodies are decomposing, as I said. There's a lot of firepower. And I should add also that we also heard what sounded like missile fire in the background. The scene is very unsecure at the moment.
Missile fire?
Yeah, among our group of observers, a lot of them are former military, law enforcement, and according to some of the journalists, in the far distance, we detected what sounded like missiles still being fired.